And I'll tell you what, Dust, you talk about a couple of guys that for whatever reason just can't seem to get enough of each other. The Nasty Boys, again, with Public Enemy. The only thing that scares me about this is every time they do battle, it gets uglier and uglier and uglier.
Yeah, and the ring is not a place to where they really thrive at. They thrive outside. And we always talk about Public Enemy bringing the plunder. Nasty Boys bringing the clubber. What a way to open up right here on the main event tonight as we get ready, counting down, as you said, to the athletes of the 90s, the football players, the wrestlers. We talk about Macho Man. So much, Eric, is going on here. It's going to be an explosive combustion situation.
Absolutely, and we're going to eliminate any confusion about the challengers and what their roles here at WCW. We're going to find out just exactly whether they're here to talk the talk or walk the walk. A lot going on. The WCW World Heavyweight Championship up for grabs tonight at the Great American Bash. The Giant, a man who has left tarnished everywhere he's gone, will be stepping into the ring with the total package. Lex Luger, who I am told by a lot of people inside of WCW, is stronger, more focused, more determined than he's ever been. This is a guy that might rack this month.
Yeah, well, can he rack him? It's very simply. I don't believe he's going to beat him with an arm hold, with a leg hold, with a backbreaker. He's got to get him up in the rack, got to weigh him down. And you know something I see right off the bat here? I see one Public Enemy and two Nasty Boys. Something's rotten right here on the stock in Baltimore.
Wait a minute. We got a solo act going on here.
Yes. I've seen that. I noticed that.
Rocco Rock in there. He's going to feel a little bit like Custer right now. He's surrounded. And I'll tell you. And the Nasty Boys. Definitely, they're crowd favorite here.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what. It looked like that, you know, we... The one.
What are you doing here, Chubby Moti? You got no business out here. Johnny ain't here. Go get your bubble butt in the back and sit out like the rest of these chumps and losers.
Well, he was 1-on-1.
Well, he may want a 1-on-1. It was, however, billed and signed and promoted as a tag team matchup. What he wants and what he gets may be two different things.
Yeah. Well, you know, the one Public Enemy that got a bad arm.
Johnny Grudge.
I got his arm in a cast. So, you know, I guarantee you that Nasty Boys want to fight.
My partner is going to whoop your butt.
Whoa.
Was so I'll just take myself to the back
yes,
with all the other winners
but
in this
building.
But
he's going to kick
you.
But he's
going to
kick
side,
it.
Turkey.
Well, right now we've got a war of words going on inside of the ring. It's going to be up to the referee here to make a decision. What are we going to do? It was signed as a tag team matchup. On the other hand, a referee appears to be sending.
Well, he's got it
Ryan
now.
Knobs to the back.
He's got it now. Pitch is running so high. Watch out.
Jerry Sags turns his back on Rocco Rock. Rocco Rock, snapmare takeover. Jerry Sags down in the center of the ring and right off the bat. Rocco Rock with the boot right between the eyes comes off the ropes and does a little pirouette into an elbow drop there.
Yeah, opportunist. Taking an opportunity right here. Now he's boogieing down a little bit. You don't want to do that to the Nasty Boys. Don't turn your back on him.
Don't taunt him. Now, big right hand.
That got him, too.
He tagged him with a right hand. Irish whip and then reverse. Jerry Sags sets up. Looked like he was going to throw for a back body drop. No!
That was a load, too. He got a load up there. Watch out now. Come in here.
Rocko Rock! He's got some momentum behind him. And Jerry Sags just drops Rocko Rock like a rock. In the center of the ring, Jerry Sags now into a scoop. Follows it up with a body slam. Center of the ring, down on his side. Rocko Rock has got to be a little careful. He takes that body slam like that. He's going to end up with a broken arm like his partner. Hip toss, takedown, up and over goes. Rocko Rock in the corner, Irish whip. Dusty, what does Rocko Rock got to do to get out of this thing?
Well, I tell you what, he can't be stationary, and that's what he's got to do is get out the way. Got to use some of his power, and maybe, I hate to say this, no, I don't. You need to get him outside where the plunder is and work him over because that's when they're at the best. That's what he needs to do.
Oh, cat-like maneuver by Rocko Rock. Up and over the top rope, out onto the floor. Rocko Rock is out onto the concrete and perfectly set up and executed. Sure, is it
hey.
There and Tony Grove? Coming
out. Watch out.
What you got? He's taking a cast off, or at least the tape around the cast.
Hey, no, he hit him with a cast.
He nailed.
He was hiding under the ring. He must have been there all day.
He nailed Jerry Sags. 1, 2, 3. Snooze, you lose.
Wow. Well, he made his way into the ring with a chair there. Should have cut him off. Went ahead and brained him a couple times. Nevertheless, we got a cast alongside the noggin of the Nasty Boys. Pelican may take a victory right here, 1-1, if you will.
You know what surprised me, Dusty? I was really surprised to see Brian Knobbs take the fact that he was sent back to the locker room so lightly.
Yeah.
I really expected to see him hanging around the ring, and you can bet that he's second-guessing himself here right now.
Yeah.
He wishes he was at ringside.
Well, yeah, well, you see that right there, and everything at this point was cool then for the Nasty Boys. But you see sneaking out here on this belly right here on TBS on the main event. Get ready for the Great American Bash. You talk about fever, this is what it's all about. Unwrapping that hand, got a full-blown cast, got a noggin standing there, got an arm, knocks him out cold in the wind. Public Enemy sneaks out, steals one right here on the main event.
This one's not over yet. The story continues, and right now, you talk about a story. This is a story of the worst haircut known to mankind. Take a look.